thank you and good afternoon. We're obviously very pleased to be back here again. I think we've had about a 7-year relationship with Scotiabank Toronto Waterfront Marathon, perhaps even longer. If I can just give you the brief background, when Folger Singh set his world records in the ages over 90s categories, it was here. He did 2 hours 29 minutes and 58 seconds for a half marathon at the age of 93. His best is 5 hours 40 at the age of 92 for a full marathon. I'd like to be happy with that if I did that on Sunday. But I think I need to translate everything he says. Although he can go through his whole life, you can actually read it on, he's got a biography called The Turbaned Tornado, available on Amazon. No plug there, honestly. But we're not quite sure. It's probably easier just to have the questions, because otherwise, you know, to cover 101 years in 20 minutes is going to be rather difficult. So maybe if we can, you know, anybody's got any questions. He did a 5K in Vancouver a couple of weeks ago to promote this race. He did that in about 40 minutes and he said he didn't even break sweat. So are there any questions perhaps? And we'll start from the front, this young lady. Is there anybody with a microphone so we can all hear what the questions are? This lady here first. Thank you, sorry.
Just a really simple question, why do you run?
It's cheaper than transport.
ਮੈਂ ਬੜਾ ਖੁਸ਼ ਹਾਂ ਇਹ ਕੰਮ ਕਰਕੇ ਮੇਰੀ ਸਿਹਤ ਠੀਕ ਆ ਮੈਂ ਹੁਣ ਪਾਈਪਾ ਨਹੀਂ ਹੁੰਦਾ ਪਰ ਮੈਂ ਥੋੜ੍ਹਾ ਥੋੜ੍ਹਾ 5-4 ਮੀਲ ਬੱਚਿਆਂ ਦੇ ਨਾਲ ਬੜਾ ਖੁਸ਼ ਹਾਂ ਕਿ ਇਹ ਕੰਮ ਕਰਦੇ ਕਰਕੇ ਮੇਰੀ ਸਿਹਤ ਠੀਕ ਆ ਇੱਕ ਮੈਂ ਪਹਿਲਾਂ ਤੋਂ ਇਹ ਕੰਮ ਕਰਦਾ ਮੈਂ ਦੇਖ ਕੇ ਤੁਹਾਨੂੰ ਭੱਜਣ ਵਾਲਿਆਂ ਨੂੰ ਬੜਾ ਖੁਸ਼ ਹਾਂ ਮੈਂ ਇੰਨੀ ਗੱਲ ਕਹਿੰਦਾ ਹੋਇਆ ਹੋਰ ਕੋਈ ਤੈਨੂੰ ਕੋਈ ਪੁੱਛਦਾ ਹੋਰ ਦੱਸਾਂ ਚੈਰਿਟੀ ਬਾਰੇ ਮੈਨੂੰ ਮੈਂ ਪਹਿਲਾਂ ਤੋਂ ਜਿਉਂ ਭੱਜਣ ਲੱਗਾ ਮੈਂ ਚੈਰਿਟੀ ਬਾਰੇ ਭੱਜਦਾ ਰਿਹਾ ਮੈਨੂੰ ਚੈਰਿਟੀ ਨੇ ਬੜਾ ਗਾਂਹ ਚ ਗਾਂਹ ਵਧਾਇਆ ਖੜ੍ਹੇ ਇਹ ਕਿੱਥੇ ਲੱਗਦੀ ਆ ਚੰਗੇ ਥਾਂ ਲੱਗਦੀ ਆ ਮੈਂ ਤਾਂ ਬੜਾ ਖੁਸ਼ ਹਾਂ ਇਹ ਕੰਮ ਕਰਕੇ ਇਹਦਾ ਭਲਾ ਹੋ ਜਾਂਦਾ ਮੇਰਾ ਵੀ ਭਲਾ ਹੋ ਜਾਂਦਾ ਕਿਸੇ ਦੇ ਨਾਲ
He says running keeps you fit all around and it's keeping him alive because by training he doesn't get tired when he's actually running but he's inspired by other people running and he feels he can do that at his age. There's not many other skills he can actually discharge but he runs for charities and he sees and he feels that the blessings of those people who benefit from the charitable work are clearly he will gain from that. And it inspires him to carry on running and doing some good work. We as Sikhs, we have three tenets of our religion. One is to remember God, secondly is to do honest day's work, and three is to share with others. He feels that he remembers God when he's running, because he blames him for, you know, unless he's getting tired. His hard day's work is his running, and because at 101 you're not really supposed to be working, but that's his work, and he shares with others through charitable work. So that's why he runs. Next question, please.
Could you summarize the training that you do for the marathon?
Marathon waste jiddan Harinder Singh coach kehnda training karni pendi aa kaafi abal ta main jo laga ਮੈਨੂੰ ਕੋਈ ਕੰਮ ਨਹੀਂ ਮੈਂ ਇਹੋ ਹੀ ਕੰਮ ਆ ਚੈਰਿਟੀ ਵਾਸਤੇ ਮੈਂ 12 ਮਹੀਨੇ ਟ੍ਰੇਨਿੰਗ ਕਰਦਾ ਇਹਨਾਂ ਤੁਰਨਾ ਵੀ ਦੌੜਨਾ ਵੀ ਉਹ ਕਿਤੇ ਨਾ ਕਿਤੇ ਮੈਰਥਨ ਤਾਂ ਹੋ ਹੀ ਰਹਿੰਦੀ ਜੋ ਮੈਂ ਲੱਗਾ ਇਹਨੂੰ ਪੂਰੀ ਕਰਦਾ ਮੈਂ
He says he actually trains throughout the year because every day he runs, jogs, walks. If I can summarize what he used to do about 10 miles, 16 kilometers of running, jogging and walking. Now it's more walking, a little bit of jogging and some running, but nevertheless he does that every day. He has got nothing else to do, he doesn't have to go to work, so for 8 hours he would spend his time trying to do being active. The training that I give him would allow him to learn how to listen to his body, how to change his running style, how to perhaps recover while he's running through his breathing. So once a week we train as a club, Sikhs in the City. You can have a look at some of the training programs which we will be putting on our website, sikhsinthecity.org. But they are more or less aligned to ordinary runners. We're, no way are we elite runners. We just do it because we want to.
I'd really like to ask him, what does he eat on a regular basis? And is it store-bought food, processed, or is it food that he cooks himself or grows himself?
ਖਾਣਾ ਕੀ ਆ ਜਿਸ ਤਰ੍ਹਾਂ ਦਾ ਮੈਂ ਪੜਿਆ ਬਿਲਕੁਲ ਘੱਟ ਖਾਂਦਾ ਮੈਂ ਬਜ਼ੁਰਗਾਂ ਨੂੰ ਖਾਣਾ ਘੱਟ ਚਾਹੀਦਾ ਜਿਸ ਖੁਰਾਕ ਨਾਲ ਪੜਿਆ ਪੰਜਾਬ ਦੀ ਖੁਰਾਕ ਨਾਲ ਉਹੀ ਖੁਰਾਕ ਮੈਨੂੰ ਚੰਗੀ ਲੱਗਦੀ ਕੋਈ ਏਡਾ ਲੰਮਾ ਇਹ ਜਾਂ ਮੀਟ ਇੱਦਾਂ ਦੀਆਂ ਚੀਜ਼ਾਂ ਨਹੀਂ ਮੈਂ ਘੱਟ ਖਾਂਦਾ ਖਾਂਦਾ ਨਹੀਂ ਅਤੇ ਜਿੰਨਾ ਜਿੰਨਾ ਥੋੜ੍ਹਾ ਥੋੜ੍ਹਾ ਬੜਾ ਤਾਂ ਖੁਸ਼ ਰਹਿਣਾ ਅਤੇ ਇਹਨਾਂ ਘਰ ਨੂੰ ਬੜਾ ਇਹੋ ਹੀ ਕੰਮ ਚੰਗਾ
He says he's lived all his life on a basic Punjabi staple diet, which is predominantly vegetarian. Well, he's a vegetarian, he's teetotal, but he eats very little. In the past, this question's been asked lots of times, and I can summarize that he eats what you and I would call a child's portion. Because if you eat too much, in Western countries and Eastern countries, or in poor countries, people die of starvation. In rich countries, people die of overeating. So he tries to get the balance right, but he eats to live rather than live to eat. He avoids anything which is excessive. He goes, the people who are best are those who cannot digest everything. Because if you can digest everything, you tend to eat everything. So he tends to eat very selectively and very little. In summary, he'd eat only, say, one toast in the morning with a cup of tea and a couple of spoons of yogurt. And at lunchtime, he'd have one chapati with a bit of dal. In the evening, he may have a cup of tea with one biscuit. And to go to his supper would only consist of perhaps one chapati and one bit of dal. So he's 5'8" and he weighs about 115 pounds. Sorry, does that answer your question? Don't be shy, ask any questions you want.
You probably said that at the beginning there. I was just wondering, because I wasn't here when you first started.
How old is he?
The gentleman was born on the 1st, according to his paperwork, he's born on the 1st of April 1911. And he started running marathons. His first marathon was at the age of 89. He had already, if I can summarize that for you, in terms of what made him run, he used to, when he was born, he was rather weak. He didn't start walking until he was about 5. And later, he always enjoyed sports. He's never been to school. He used to avoid school, run away from it even. But he enjoyed watching sport, taking part in sport. Then by 1947, there was other things to do, because during the partition of India, there were a lot of people were displaced. So for the next 57 years, he had a short break of not running and just raising a family as a farmer. Then there was two traumatic incidents in his life. One was the death of his son in front of him, and one, but I could say this because he doesn't understand it, right? Because otherwise it just brings bad memories for him. And the death of his wife, he had to escape that because it was haunting him, as it were. He went to England to be with his youngest son, and there, in order, he still felt a pull of the memories, and but he had to distract himself to a new focus in life. So he started doing what he used to enjoy as a young man, and he started running, mainly challenging old age pensioners to a 100 meter sprint or maybe 200 meter sprint, and he doesn't like losing. And he came across two gentlemen, Amarik Singh and Ajit Singh, who were marathon runners. They felt that he ought to try that. He extended the distances and started raising money for charities, and he can't tell the difference between a mile and a kilometer. If only the course measurers would do the same, that, I'm sure we'd all be grateful. It wouldn't be easy. It wouldn't be too difficult to run 26 kilometres, would it? Right. But anyway, he thought he'd done a 20-mile run, but it was only 20k. He came home and he was watching a marathon race on telly, and he was concerned about. Well, he was just curious as to why these people carried on running, and he thought he'll try some of that. And he then tried to enter the London Marathon, but he missed the deadline. And eventually somebody introduced him to me. I'm a complete nutcase, I do marathons all the time. On Sunday it'll be my 62nd marathon. So we was introduced, and I only had 10 weeks to train him from 20k to 42k. He's the best student I've ever had. If I said we were doing 10k, he'd say why not 20? So he was so keen as mustard, and he absolutely went hell for leather for it. And in his first attempt, he did 6 hours 54, second year he did 6.54, third year he did 6.45, fourth year he did 6.02, this is all London Marathons. And I realised that he could go break the 6 hour barrier. And we found the best race is the Scotiabank Trotter Waterfront Marathon. It's a fast course, people are lovely, they support you all the way. And he came over here and he did 5 hours 40. 6 weeks later he was injured. He went to do New York, but he had to do it because Sikhs were suffering mistaken identity hate crime attacks after 9/11, and we went there to help educate the Americans as to who Sikhs were. But he had to finish it 7.5 hours. He did not want to run anymore because he felt disappointed. So, but I had to persuade him, because a good coach will look after the body and mind of the people he's training, or she's training. And I persuaded him to run one more time. He did 6.07 in the London. Then I felt he could retire on a high, but he had one more ambition. He wanted to be the oldest marathon run ever. And he can't hurry the clock, so we had to wait for another number of years, 7 years. In the meantime, we went to break all the other shorter records to keep him in shape. And last year, he came back and became the first person over 100 to complete a marathon. He still wanted to be the oldest, but the honour of being the very first person clearly will stay with Scotiabank Toronto Waterfront Marathon. But he did want to run his home run, which was London, and he also did that earlier this year. He was 22 minutes faster in London than he was here, but that's because I made him actually train with some more. Any other questions?
Harmander, can you remind us what event he's running on Sunday? Is he doing the marathon?
No, after, as soon as he crossed the race at the finishing line in London this year, I had to make the assessment. It was a cruel one, but nevertheless it was a necessary one. He's not running any more marathons or full or half. The most I would let him run is a 10k, but ideally 5k is what I'm going to allow him, and he's doing the 5k here, and it's clearly, we don't want to call it a farewell run, it's clearly just something to say a thank you. He said earlier today he wants to thank the people of Toronto and Canada as a whole for being so supportive and loving to him, and he just wants to be with the community. He wants to be with all communities because he feels he's the man of the people and he loves the people here. 5K, I've told him to take it easy. He reckons he can still do about 40 minutes. Any other questions?
What do you think are his chances of getting into the Guinness Book of Records?
He's got absolutely no chance of getting into the Guinness Book of Records, because the Guinness Book of Records has their own rules, and it's a private company and they're entitled to have their rules. Their rules are that you need to have a birth certificate. In developing countries such as India and in Africa and elsewhere, many of them don't have birth certificates now, let alone 100 years ago, so he cannot produce it. But to him, when we were asked, it was suggested to him, what does he think about it, and he said, who is Guinness? It's more important for him, he says, the people who saw him run, have seen him run, ran with him. It's more important to keep them satisfied rather than just having records. Records are just a byproduct of what he does.
Hermander, perhaps you can talk a little bit about the impact and the support you've had from the local community in Toronto, the local Sikh community here.
Well, I actually want to say it's been absolutely fantastic. Each year we come, we're hosted, we're overfed, right? And we're taken around everywhere. But it's not just the Sikh community. I really want to emphasize that if I can just talk about Sikhs in the City as well, which was the name of our running club, it's a multi-faith club. And what we pioneered the act of interfaith relay marathons. We have men and women from 9 different religions in our club. And what we do is say a marathon is a mark of human endeavor. If we can share that load with other people, we can show that different races and religions can work together to achieve a common goal, racial and religious harmony. So we pioneered that. And so in Toronto, we do have Sikhs in the City of Toronto, and it's actually headed by a Chinese girl, Lee. So I don't know whether she's here, but she heads the Sikhs in the City of Toronto. We have Sikhs in the City of Frankfurt. We have Sikhs in the City of Hong Kong. In Hong Kong, it's actually run more by Sikhs, which is ironic. In London, we have 62 members, and we are the biggest club of a park run series. So we have the youngest, a 10-year-old, who can run 5K in about 20 minutes, and we have Farja Singh. Have you all heard about age grading? Farja Singh's age grading for a 5K is 179%. So 100% is a world record. But coming back to what's just been asked, in Toronto, we've been coming this for the last number of years, as I say, and each year, more and more people are inspired. We don't want to use the word inspired, lightly. People have actually come out, and this year, more than 100 Sikhs, we believe closer to 150 Sikhs, in fact, are going to be running with him, people who would have normally not got out of their front doors. And so it's truly been an inspiration. We've had people taking photographs of him everywhere, including medical clinics and others. They use him as an example to move people on from the sedentary lifestyle that we often fall into.
Are there any additional questions from anyone? If there are none, then I just want to take this opportunity to thank Farja and Hermander for coming to speak to us today.
Okay.